after the disaster of Madam Usha, we were relaxing. We went to Lhasa. This is part one. In Nepal, kerosene is available like this. This is a shoemaker, Leo's house, an office, his partner, the bungalow, the car, on rent. Chinese people never purchased the property. They perhaps don't have the right. Royal Nepal Airlines, though we went by China Air, this is a Buddhist priest. Leo doesn't like his photographs to be taken. See the ocean-like clouds. Oh, ocean. Is it ocean or a cotton bedsheet, cotton spread all over, or a cloud, or a white to hike? What is this white? We are much above the sea level. Oh, wonderful, wonderful Rajai. In winter, you need it. Clouds from the window. This aircraft has everything that modern aircraft needs. Most sophisticated. Even it warned me personally to switch off the camera. They permit afterwards. This is the Lhasa Airport. Lhasa Airport, one of the most beautiful airports of the world, because it's surrounded by tiny hills, very big plateau. Linda Falling and a Chinese police officer. We can see this is the airport from outside. Lhasa Airport. The cars here, car rides on the right side of the road. Most of the cars are left-hand drives. Green farms. Linda Falling, cutie, beautiful lady, Chinese speaking guy. Lhasa, modern city, very wide, 8 lanes, 6 lanes roads, but still bicycles and bicycle rickshaws are seen. Sweeper is seen and fire star is also seen. We went for a formal drink over there. Chinese, Tibetan folks. This is the Potala Palace from behind. Early morning shot. Lhasa is semi-awake and semi-sleeping. Very early morning. China is 2 hours ahead of India. This is Potala Palace from behind. This is again behind. This is a Buddha's monastery. Yellow Buddha they call it. Oh, wonderful. Solar cooker. Yes, the water is hot also. They say these temples, tin, are golden. Could be. Pure gold, they say. The typical Tibetan symbols, monks gathered. This is a mall where 2 butter lamps are continuously 24 hours. 2 sides, many butter lamps are burning. Something like Indian temples. The mall, as seen from the temple terrace. This is the Potala Palace front view. We will be visiting it later on. Linda Falling with a drink break. I have to take a break here. This is a heroine of 7 years in Tibet. I did recognize her. First he was reluctant, then permitted to give me the photograph. I was so excited about it. This is the godfather of Leo. We presented him something, Shiva's symbolic thing, Lord Shiva with his tortoise and ox. This is the summer palace of Dalai Lama. The beautiful garden as you can see, all ingredients so suggest the summer. Potala Palace, an extraordinary sight to watch. Linda falling in a restaurant. From 4th Dalai Lama onwards, from 4th Lama onwards, they have buried all the Lamas over there. And Dalai Lama, who escaped, is in exile. China has concentrated something like concentration camp with the Italian Colonel Gazian and all those people did. They have cornered this religious place, multi-story building, so old. You can see the beauty of Potala Palace and a Chinese girl. Again, there is a man-driven cycle rickshaws. A single picture shows the religious mentality of local Tibetan people. Behind me is the Potala Palace, front view, and some extraordinary air-conditioned cars too. The Chinese administration. See the wonderful bicycle and a taxi. This is a Chinese museum. It was a unique museum. Don't miss this part 2, as it's very long. I have to divide the video into 2.